everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Fasten your seatbelts for one of the great divisional rivalries in the NFL. This is the first of two games between these teams this year, and you know it's going to be entertaining. It's the Bengals going up against the Steelers. So with kickoff straight ahead, we'll check in with our broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, and Heinz Field. Coming up, it's a rematch from last year's AFC wildcard round between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Pittsburgh Steelers. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, we look at this Steeler ball club entering play. They come in off a loss in the opener last week. That one was on the road. Now they get their first taste here of home cooking.
And what they're hoping to do is feed off the energy of the home crowd. Great tailgate, great fan support. Let's see if they can put it to good use.
Meanwhile, for the Bengals here, they come off a good win in the opener on the road, and they get a second road game here.
Yeah, the schedule makers didn't really do them any favors, but if they can win here and get to 2-0 on the road, they could be well set up for the rest of the year.
So the Steelers' offense getting set for their first drive. They're led onto the field by a man who needs no introduction, Ben Roethlisberger.
An absolute prototype for what you draw up as a big, strong quarterback that has to stay in the pocket and make big throws with people all around him and even hanging on him, and still has that type of strength to get the ball downfield. Ben Roethlisberger, an absolute rock in the pocket, but he also can escape and make big plays that way as well.
This is Murray, and he's going to be stopped here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Play action. It's Roethlisberger. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. And here's the offense today that hopes to get off to a strong start. Little trouble thus far on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 11.
Third and 11, five in the secondary now.
Nickel look. On third down, Roethlisberger. This is caught by Antonio Brown. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. This is taken at the 15. Oh, what a move. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Here come the Bengals now to take over. They'll be led out by a two-time Pro Bowler in his sixth season. It's Andy Dalton.
And in 2015, prior to hurting his thumb and being unable to finish the season, you just heard his teammates rave about Andy Dalton's jump in leadership, where he actually took over the team, really assumed the role of being the starting quarterback, and carried himself that way as well.
They go play action here on first down. This one grabbed by A.J. Green. A.J. Green! And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A.J. Green, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. He's tough to contain as it is, but in man coverage with a pretty deep pass downfield, really tough to contain.
And it's so difficult because every play, you've got to consider he might try and run past you. So your goal as a defensive back is to give him plenty of cushion, meaning lots of space between you and him. If he wants to catch the short stuff, come up and secure the tackle, hit him a bunch during the game, and try and keep him in front. But if you turn your head for a second, if your concentration wanes,
bye-bye.
He just takes off and goes. And I think that's what we just saw there.
After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And the Steelers set to take the field. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out with a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go. First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But a guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
So the offense readies for a second and four. On second down, Roethlisberger. Shorts on the reception over the middle. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. They'll get a couple yards on that one. And that'll make it third and one. And the Bengals starting defensive unit now.
Ray Maluga competes very hard as a linebacker. Very difficult to block and keep out of the play.
So third down, just 1 yard to go. Third and one, it's Roethlisberger. He gets it to Brown, complete. And he brings this up to the 46, good enough for the first. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Now the offense lining up first and 10. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. Give him three on the play, and that'll make it second down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position. It's actually utilized more of a scat back in this spot because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. But he's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
there. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. Decent chunk of yardage still left here, second and seven. From the pistol, they run it with Murray. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him four on the carry, and it'll make this a third and about two.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
So they run it on second down. Now let's see what third down brings here for the offense. They'll come out in the pistol. Third and two. Now Roethlisberger. Oh, they would have gotten the conversion if he could hold on. Instead, the drop means it'll be fourth down.
After After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
Here's Jordan Berry now. On for his second punt, he'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is, at the 6-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was really easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. First carry now. This is Hill. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. First drive for this offense today, and our first chance to get a look at Tyler Eifert.
And he's part of the new wave of tight ends in the NFL. They use him in every position, sometimes even by themselves as a wide receiver.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. It's 2nd down. Dalton looking. And over the middle, it's LaFell. It's a gain of 5. And that'll bring up a 3rd down. And the starting defensive unit here for Pittsburgh.
Lawrence Timmons comes from a long line of productive Florida State players. And when I say productive, I usually mean spectacular.
Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's 3rd down for this offense. They'll try and run for it. Here's Hill. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
And that's why you see so many teams play a 3-4 defense, because that set gives you a lot of flexibility about where to bring pressure from, and it's hard for an offense to pick it up. Left side, right side, up the middle, especially with some really flexible linebackers.
With it is Brown. Excellent return that time, 26 yards. And the Steeler offense, they're set up nicely as they take over. The Steelers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. Took the words right out of my mouth. They come out here in the eye. Brown, the lone receiver left. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. And it's complete to Ladarius Green. It's a gain of 20 that time. And it's good enough for a Pittsburgh first down. We heard them talk before the game about utilizing the intermediate passing game this week. It works for them there. They move the chains.
And we saw them work on it in practice as well. And most teams take a period at a time to work on different things. They put a couple of periods of work into the intermediate passing game. And now we know exactly why. They got the look that they were seeking, and they were able to take advantage of it. As the guy carrying the ball, your eyes are going to direct your feet, and you're hoping they carry you to the open spaces. But it's awfully difficult at times because you have so many things you have to look out for. Where's the line blocking? Where's the traffic coming from? Tough to find open spots.
Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, third down.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. He had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
And they've got an extra defensive back out there now on third and 13. A fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. And he comes back with one complete. And he's brought down after a good game. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. They come out here in the eye. And here we go on first and goal. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. So we'll get a second and goal when we come back. It's a close game here early on. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number two, and they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Now they'll run, Murray, and he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. DeMarco Murray, his second touchdown on the season. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And nothing special there. They show they were going to run the football. They ran it. They got it in.
Like old-time football, right? Hey, this is exactly what we're going to do. Straight-ahead power, and they got it done.
It's good, and we're all tied at seven apiece. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Muscles him off. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They begin the drive with Hill. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Second down, 8. They'll come out in the pistol. Again, it's Hill. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first. So Jeremy Hill got the call there, and he's trying to pick his yardage back up. 2 years ago, Charles, he was over 1,100. Last year, below 800.
Just never got going with any consistency throughout the 2015 season. You know his determination is sky high for this one. The Steelers insert their nickel defense on third down.
Yeah, they add a DB. Now Dalton, and Eifert has it. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Okay, when the big guy runs a corner route, you're asking a lot no matter who's covering him. Doesn't matter whether it's a linebacker or a defensive back. Yeah. He usually has the advantage because of his body type.
A first down throw coming for Dalton. Green's got it over the middle. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. Call it a gain of 5. And it'll bring up a second down. 5 yards left for the offense. It's second down. Dalton throwing on second down. Caught Eifert over the middle. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He had told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. And just a simple, basic neutral zone infraction here, partner.
Yeah, when you're ready to launch and go get the quarterback, sometimes you take off a bit too fast.
Following the penalty, it's Hill. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain there on first and 5, and it leaves him with a more standard second down. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They send Green to the left on his own. Second down, Dalton. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time, spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
And on 3rd and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive. Third down from the gun, Dalton. And able to find Green. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Well, the coaches mentioned they weren't as concerned about big play offense. They thought they could get some shorter, quicker stuff and be consistent. And that's kind of what they showed there.
What they saw in preparation, what they saw on film, is a defense that likes to get out fast in terms of coverage, meaning they either bail out or they give them a lot of space to throw the underneath stuff, so they decide they take advantage of it and worked on it hard in practice this week.
Now a first down carry. It's Hill fighting through, and he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2.
A lot of people call the toss a probing play to see what they can get against the defense, to see how they adjust and react. Their probing's working pretty well. That was a very nice run.
It's 2nd down. Dalton looking. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
And those first downs do add up. The offense keeps the ball moving downfield and keeps their defense on the bench, giving them a chance to rest.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and goal. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
This one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down. And looky there, Charles, just acquired, already making an impact on the defensive side of the football.
Maybe not a superstar, but he does a few things well, and I think they'll emphasize that in his new role with this team.
Line of scrimmage at the 4. Here's 3rd and goal. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. Back now. As I search for my cue card here, there we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play.
Well read.
Yeah, thank you. And this seemingly endless drive continues. Dalton on 3rd and goal. He's got it. Touchdown, Bengals. Brian Hartline, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Bengals are in for 6. So on 3rd and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
And he's brought down after a good game. And, of course, the defense is going to accept this penalty. Here on 1st down. And this one complete to Marcus Wheaton. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Now Roethlisberger to throw on 2nd down. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
The Bengals with two extra DBs, a nickel look on third.
Blanketing the passing lanes.
Roethlisberger now to throw on third down. He gets it to Brown, complete. 23 yards on the play. And they're going to speed things up here. On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Hauled in by Wheaton over the middle. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Six yards to go here on second down. Another pistol look here. Ben to throw again. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He was looking for DeMarco Murray out of the backfield. And it'll be third down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude. But I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Now they got to get to the 23 here on third. And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third. On third down, Roethlisberger, a screen to Bell. And he'll be brought. And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. So on fourth down, the Steelers call on the number of Chris Boswell for the field goal try. This from 44 yards away. And Boswell's kick is good. And they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10. So it's a seven-play drive, but it stalls out in the end.
Let's credit the defensive front seven. They were a little leaky at the start of the drive, but they stiffened toward the end.
To just four as they kick it away and turn things over to their D. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Getting set to go again, Andy Dalton marches back onto the field. And he's been good. Two first half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and throw them on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. So here we go, first and 10 now. Now Dalton with a first and 10. Caught Eifert over the middle. And he eventually goes down, but not before reaching the 30-yard line. Nice completion there for Andy Dalton. And Charles, you worked some of his games when he was at TCU. Now you've worked his games in the NFL. What progression have you seen?
I've seen a guy took over as a freshman in college and got better and better each year. Always added a little bit more to his game, got stronger. But the best part about him is open.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on. And the Steelers signal for another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. And Nugent puts it through, and that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
Back out Nugent now after the field goal as he'll send it away. It's Marcus Wheaton now to return it. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. So we have reached halftime here, and it's the visiting Bengals out in front as we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half.
The Steelers trail at home at halftime. The Bengals will want to come out after the half and really put the pressure on from the start.
So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half. First and 10. In double coverage, Dalton finds Green. And that goes with a 66-yard touchdown. He'll take the early advantage. Second and 2 coming up. Murray's got it on the run. And this 5-play drive goes for a touchdown. We're brand new at 7. Bengals come out on 3rd and 4. Quick pass and he finds Brian Hartline. And now they get in for the touchdown. The Bengals is up now by 7. Now to late in the first half. Dalton has the completion across the middle. And he'll end up at the 30-yard line before being tackled. But they end up coming away with just 3 on the drive. So that'll do it for us here in Orlando for the call of the second half. Let's hand it back over to Brandon and Charles. Brandon.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number 3. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them.
Now he's hit, and Dalton lost the football. Oh, the spin.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
He's going to air one out. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time. And they're going to face a third down.
I know I'm not giving up credit to the defenders because that pass was incomplete. But come on, it was A.J. Green. I always expect him to come up with the ball.
Yeah, on those deep routes especially, even on incompletions, it's fun to watch him run those routes.
It certainly is, but he eats up ground and he usually goes up and gets it.
Third down, a shot here for Dalton. He's got time in the pocket. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Now Brown. And Antonio Brown yet to get back on his feet. Apparently shaking up that last play. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. They'll try and get the running game going here with Murray. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this third and eight. From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. And incomplete here on third down. He was trying to get it to Cecil Shorts that time. And that'll bring up fourth down.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Here's Jordan Berry now, as he's on to punt for Pittsburgh. He'll look to set up his blockers. 51 yards on the punt there, and the Bengals take possession. The Bengals getting set to go. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll try to get the offense going with Hill. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. Stephon Tuitt, the one that got him down. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock.
They run it again with Hill. Ooh, with a juke. And he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set.
There goes Jeremy Hill. 20, 10, 5. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. A big play there for Cincinnati. And even 60 yards.
Three and
yards to go for the offense. First down and goal from that 5-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
And now to the air, Dalton. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
Take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Brandon LaFell, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bengals add on to their lead. And that time, he came out of the slot for that big play downfield for the score.
I think what we just saw there, partner, was what we call scheming a guy open. Put him in the slot, know that he has tremendous speed. What you're doing with your other receivers is likely running shorter routes to draw the attention closer to the line of scrimmage, to give him a chance to get downfield and turn it into a one-on-one route, often against the safety. You like your odds when he's running against the safety. His speed usually wins, and it did on that play.
After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. Wheaton will return it. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
And if they want to keep this drive alive, they'll need 8 yards here on third down. They come out with one back and three tight ends. A fake to Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Adam Jones. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
You've got to know as a quarterback that's going to be tough to outthink this guy in the defensive backfield. He's been at it 11 years now, so he knows all the ins and outs of the position, and he's in the right spot there to come up with the interception.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. Second down, Dalton. Green with a catch left side. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Brandon, as long as we've been covering this league, every time we see a receiver that does not have a big-time game, You know that it's a long week for everyone around him. And boy, it's paid off for him this week. He is prepared, locked in, and demanding the football and getting it.
He told you that pregame that he was ready. I wasn't there. I was standing alongside talking to his teammate, but he said he was ready. It showed.
My favorite part is he was telling me he was ready while he kept pacing in front of me. I mean, he's like a thoroughbred, just out of the gates. And what he's done this week is found the ball early, meaning just get it to me and let me make plays. And that's exactly what he's done.
It's second down. Dalton looking. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And, boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
They send Green to the left on his own. And it'll be Dalton again. That's caught at the 3. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it second and goal.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Another chance for Dalton. They set up the screen to Hill. He had a quick little spin move, but the door shut fast as he's dropped. A gain of 4 on the play, and that'll make it third and goal. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one smoke.
And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Brian Hartline, his second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21 points. After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. Wheaton will return it. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. It's just going.
Pressure up the middle, and down he goes. Domitapeko busting through to get him for a loss of 6. And they weren't in zone coverage, they were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Back now in Pittsburgh. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. On second down, Roethlisberger. And it's caught over the middle by the tight end, Green. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll make it third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
Well, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of the difference between driving on those paved roads and those country roads that have those potholes in them.
And how about this? A fake. But he will not make the first down marker. That'll be a turnover on downs.
Anytime a fake doesn't work, we usually focus our attention on the guys that were unsuccessful. But how about the defensive guys? They have to plan all week. They have to prepare all week. Special teams, it looked like they were educated for that one.
Educated on their toes and getting a big stop. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
On second down, Hill. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Third down, a shot here for Dalton. And able to find Green. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. It'll be a gain of 4, and it'll be fourth down.
Receivers love having the reputation of being go-to guys on third down, and he was fighting like he really wanted to have that reputation, didn't he? I mean, he came very close to making that a first down.
Broke the one tackle, but couldn't spring himself free. McCarron. And all the gamble. Fails. It's incomplete. They pass up the 3, fake it. It doesn't work. Well, there's two sides here. I guess you could pinpoint and look at the offense and say, oh, man, what a disaster. Hey, the defense, though, they came through.
Preparation's the key to everything. And when you're on the defensive side of the ball and in special teams meetings, you prepare for plays like this. And in this case, they were actually able to win it.
The Steelers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
Now Roethlisberger on first down. Out left here, it's complete to Wheaton. 7 yards on the play, and it'll be a second down. Murray, the lone setback. And he'll get it up the middle. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. They got 2 of the 3 they needed there. Leaves him with third and just a yard.
The best defensive lineman They play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
I see an extra defensive back on the field. A little surprise here on third and one. And now on the pitch, the ball's loose. And the Bengals grab it.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. And Dalton hands to Hill. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. A gain of three, second down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take. Puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Just a one-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at six.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, are usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
Give them a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and that will extend their lead even further. So it's three more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the three whenever you can.
Back out Nugent now after the field goal as he'll send it away. On the return, here's Justin Gilbert. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly
right. You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
And these numbers, not what he wants to see, that's for sure. You know, last week, and we were talking about this, so crisp with his reads and progressions, but that just hasn't been the case here in this one.
Extremely sharp.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Ray Malaluga in there to drop him with his first sack of 2016. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now Ben on third and long. Now a desperation throw into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Adam Jones. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games. And now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
The Bengals offense now, they head back onto the field. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League, you're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment.
There goes Jeremy Hill. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. And my friend, I think it's safe to say that this game is pretty much deceased at this point. It's taken a knee, so to speak.
It is definitely this victory formation. Take the snap, take the knee, call it a night, you know, call it a game, call it whatever. I agree with you totally. I don't think there's much left to get except for those who want to run up the score.
I knew this was over about a minute ago when you took your stat sheet and just flipped it over your shoulder in the trash can.
Yeah, that's similar to the guys cutting tape off right before the game's over. We know this thing's done.
And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. Wheaton will return it. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20. Call it the 21-yard line. Now the Steelers' offense gets ready to get back onto the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Face mask penalty. And Charles, you were a defender. You know sometimes in the heat of the moment, it's hard to keep your hands away from that face mask.
Sometimes you just get out of position as a defender when you're trying to make a tackle. So you end up flailing away and your hand gets into the wrong spot.
Following the penalty, it's Murray. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
Wasn't that long ago that the NFL guys really didn't adopt much from the college game. But one thing that has crept in there is spreading things out, opening things up, not even just in tempo, but maybe getting better line splits and spreading the field. I think that would be a great strategy right now to try and open things up in the run game. When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And it looks like we've got a dime set. And now Roethlisberger signals for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. So a 3rd and 8. On 3rd down, Roethlisberger. Hard throw, incomplete. Sammy Coates, the intended target there. And that's going to make it 4th down. Here's Jordan Berry now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They have the big cushion here in the final stages of this one. I don't know if there's any better feeling than being up big on the road.
There really can't be, because for a team to go on the road and win in the NFL, that's huge to begin with. But just think about all the preparation that went into it. When they first started talking about this game, leading up to it during the week, going on the road, unfamiliar city, obviously, unfamiliar hotel. No one's going to be with you once you get to the stadium. They're all going to be against you. You name it. All those things they had to deal with, they're able to conquer them and do it convincingly.
Yeah, they did it very convincingly, and now the final moments of this one. And now a little bit of a losing skid here. Only two games, but still two straight losses. How do they rebound?
Well, able to shake off the first one. Most people say, okay, sometimes we're going to drop one. But then you get to the second one. Now it's imperative that they get together and find a way to stop it. You start getting into three-game losing streaks, all sorts of bad things begin to happen.
So for Cincinnati, it's a dream start. Two wins in two early road games. And they'll be back home next week to take on the Denver Broncos. Meanwhile, for Pittsburgh, they'll drop to 0-2. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Philly to face off with the Eagles. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. With that, we sign off from Heinz Field.